us at the Evansville Coliseum.
You know, a lot of things are happening right here, right now. People are getting run over, speeding, getting run over. Doug, this week, you've got Cowabunga, and I want to see what a turtle looks like when you run over and you splatter him in the road. Sam Lowe, this is going to be your chance. Cowboy boot match, you come in the ring with a pair of cowboy boots on. So do you, Eddie Marlin. The one that gets them off the other guy wins, and you can use them. And Brickhouse Brown, the people are about to see a history-making thing. They are about to see the name of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert go down in history in the USWA, because Jerry Lawler is fixing to get a present for me right here on this program. And Brickhouse, if you've got any guts at all, show up, because these are eyes of a crazy man. I came back to be number one. My brother's going to be number one. Sam Lowe's going to beat Eddie Mullen's head in, and I am going to reign the new king of the USWA. And if anybody gets in my way, I'm going to run you over.
Well, a few minutes ago, Bruno and Lee and Harris were out here yelling and screaming. We were showing you part of a videotape of what happened when the belts were held up. Let's go back and take a look at the rest of what happened down there.
The crowd behind Jarrett and Gaylord, 100%. Everyone's on their feet trying to explain to Frank Morrell what happened with the chain. Frank Morrell going to reverse the decision. Don Harris, Byron Lee, nail him right across the back of the head.
Well, they looked like he was going to. He grabbed Jarrett's wrist, and about that time he got waylaid. And all four men going at it. Jarrett firing away on Don Harris. Nails him hard. Gaylord is up on Brian Lee. And it looks like Frank Morrell is taking the belt. He's saying nobody's getting the belt. He's holding them up. I assume pending a review on this situation, nobody's going to get the belt.
Well, and of course, that's exactly what happened. The decision was that there had been outside interference by Downtown Bruno, and therefore the belts would be held up. And that was verified by the USWA committee, and the belts have, in fact, been held up. There will be a rematch coming up between those teams, though, and we'll tell you more about that later on. Another match which occurred a few days ago was a 19-man battle royal. Now, in this one, every man for himself in there, and we had wondered how you always wonder in a battle royal how pairings may end up, partners can end up facing each other. And with $5,000 at stake, a lot of times you can have strange things happen. Well, we've got a bit of videotape of that battle royal, and let's take a look at what happened there.
Brickhouse Brown, say no way is he going to go in there and split any money. He's coming after the $5,000. Both men fighting tooth and nail as Brickhouse sticks the fifth. Brickhouse Brown with an atomic knee drop sends Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert up and over the top rope and out of the battle royal as Brickhouse Brown coming out victorious, winning $5,000.
Look out, Brick. Here comes Doug Gilbert, Sam Lowe back into the ring. Eddie Gilbert nails referee Jerry Calhoun, and now it's 3-on-3. Oh, look out. Here comes a tough pile driver. Oh, man, they nailed Brickhouse hard. You know, for a minute, with the way Brickhouse has acted before in the past, I thought he'd split the money with Gilbert. But he said, no, I told you earlier tonight what kind of a man I am. I'm my own man. He said he's got a woman that takes a lot of money. He wanted a $5,000, and he won it fair and square.
Hey, now leave me out alone.
Stop it, the match is over. It's over.
Eddie Gilbert has split the check in his tight after Doug Gilbert and Sam Lowe jumping Brickhouse. Eddie just took the check, shoved it down his tight. Telling Eddie Gilbert that if he doesn't get out of the ring off of Brickhouse, he'll be fined. Eddie Marlin going up into the ring. Doug Gilbert and Sam Lowe jumping Eddie Marlin now. Gilbert just nails Eddie Marlin with that chair.
Well, we need to get somebody in here to help them. Eddie Marlin at their mercy. I assume most of the wrestlers that are in this battle royal are back in the showers or on their way home after they've been eliminated. I don't know if they'd help Brickhouse, but I sure know somebody would help Eddie Marlin if anybody's back there in the dressing room. Eddie Marlin, a bloody mess, finally out of the ring. He's got on the mic.
Eddie Marlin in there, calling for Jerry Lawler as Sam Lowe and Doug Gilbert continue to pound on Eddie Marlin and Brickhouse Brown. Marlin in bad shape, bleeding now after being hit with that chair. Up into the ring, pulls the strap down, goes to clean it out.
Lawler's in there nailing them all. He's got both the Gilberts. Brickhouse back up to his feet. Brickhouse on Gilbert. Lawler nails Sam Lowe. Lawler and Brickhouse cleaning house after one of the sickest things I have ever seen in professional wrestling. One of the most disgusting and cowardly acts I have ever seen. Traded by anybody.
Thank goodness Lawler got there to help Brickhouse after an incredibly disgusting display.
Oh, let's look up in the air. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's Super Lawler. Yeah, every time they tear somebody down, when Eddie Marlin will stick his nose into my business, well, I'm going to take your nose, buddy, and I'm going to cram it. Jerry Lawler, you want to save Brickhouse Brown? Brickhouse Brown, the people didn't get to see what happened when I took the microphone. You were like a brother to me. I trusted you. I thought we would split the $5,000, and you turned on me in front of all those people. Now, I want to tell Mr. Old Man Eddie Marlin something. Stay out of my business. Stay out of my brother's business and stay out of Sam Lowe's. Because when you get on the microphone and tell me to quit, well, I'm going to do it just a little harder because I've always been a little rebellious. I didn't like people telling me what to do, Eddie Marlin. I don't like...
Eddie Marlin, face to face, right here.
Listen, let me tell you something, Eddie Gilbert. First, I want to talk to you, Sam Lowe. You shouldn't even be out here in front of the cameras. You should be running around the ring with your little camera. And I'm going to tell you one thing. I'm going to show you the color of your own blood, because you're going to be in a ring with me, and you're going to have on cowboy boots, and I am too. And I'm going to take your boots and bust that head. Now, let me tell you something, Eddie Gilbert and Doug Gilbert. I should have fired you last week, but I didn't. It's because Jerry Lawler and Brickhouse Brown said, don't fire him. We can do more damage to him in the ring than you can by firing him. That's the only reason you are here today talking about the match.
No, wait a minute. You know, I can stand a lot of things. I can stand people come out here calling me this, that, and the other. But for you, the promoter, the man that represents the USWA, to come out here and tell me the reason why you didn't fire me is because Jerry Lawler and Brickhouse Brown said, we'll kick their butts, Eddie Marlin, let us have a match with them. The only reason why you didn't fire us, Eddie Marlin, is because we are the USWA now. I'm talking about the Gilbert. We are the Gilbert. You see, we represent the USWA. You wouldn't sell ticket one if it wasn't for me and my brother. You would not have anybody come to these matches if it wasn't for us. You would have an empty arena there because we are the hottest commodity in wrestling now. The people don't care anything about Jerry Lawler. The people don't care anything about Brickhouse Brown. They don't care about Bill Dundee. They don't care about Jeff Jarrett. They care about the Gilberts. We are stars. Wherever we walk, people flock. And you're lucky that I'm even wrestling here.
You're lucky that you're wrestling here, because if it hadn't been for Lawler and Brickhouse Brown, you would have been fired last week. You wouldn't even be here on this.
The truth is, Eddie Marlin, if right now, if I said I was quitting or something like that, you'd drop right down on your knees. You would say, please, please, Gilbert boys, please don't leave this place. You don't know right now. The ratings have come up since I've been back. All the crowds have been coming in to see me. I know I'm a star. I know I'm the man here now. You can't do without me. I'm irreplaceable, sir. Because I want to tell you something. You're real lucky that I'm even working for this rinky-dink promotion.
Well, let me tell you something, young man. If it's so rinky-dink, you hit the road right now. I don't have to have you. I don't need you. Hit the road right now.
hit the
what
road.
What are you saying? You're firing me here on TV?
Drop down.
You're firing me.
Out the door.
You can't fire me here.
Out the door.
You can't do that.
Well, Gilbert finally pushed Eddie Marlin too far, I think. As Eddie said, he felt like he should have fired him after the that disgusting display that you saw the videotape from that occurred at the 19-man Battle Royal.
You can't fire me!
You can't fire me. Eddie Marlin seems to be proving he can, in fact, fire him. And there they went. I don't know if we got a camera going that way. Let's see if Eddie does in fact make sure they get out of the building or what the situation. Yeah, there they go. They're out in the parking lot. Gilbert's still screaming. Doug Gilbert there in wrestling tights. Doug's scheduled in a match here in just a few minutes. But, hey, getting into a little bit of a shoving match there, and Eddie Gilbert coming back. Eddie Marlin still insisting, hey, get out of here. That looks like Doug's car there. Oh, shoves Eddie down. Well, that's the kind of guy you're dealing with here, and hot stuff Eddie Gilbert. Yeah, there's Lawler out to kind of even it up a little bit. And I see Eddie Gilbert backing toward the car now. The door is open. And, yeah, he just gets in there and get him on out of the parking lot. Hey, look out. Whoa. My goodness. Hit by the car. Eddie's checking him out there. Stay right here. Lawler. What? Eddie's calling for some help from, there's Jerry Calhoun and Bill Dundee helping out. Rex King out. Now, Jerry looks like he's helping his own cause and getting up there. Well, boy, he's going to be mighty sore at the least, let me tell you that. Eddie Gilbert went flying out of the parking lot there after being fired by Eddie Marlin. I get Jerry back in the building here and make sure, get him checked out, make sure everything's all right. Well, boy, I tell you what, you deal with guys like the Gilberts, and I got to agree, Eddie should have fired him last week after all of that happened, but Jerry Lawler at Brickhouse Brown says, no, don't fire him. Let us get him in the ring. Well, in hindsight, maybe it would have been better if he had just been fired before that. Well, I'd really like to get Eddie out here and see if we can get the situation, but... I don't know. Maybe we should take a break and check it out, and then we'll be back in just a moment. Stay with us.